This week's The Rahman Experience is brought to you by the Jacksonville Free Press newspaper, bringing quality urban news to you each week for more than 30 years. JacksonvilleFreePress.com. TheMPNutrition.com, your one-stop shop for supplements, workout plans, and nutrition advice. And Heart SEO, from web design to social media marketing and search engine management, they can make your business soar. And now, come on and join me for one of the hottest podcasts in the country. It is The Rahman Experience.
Just like on the earth, through death comes life.
There is something in the atmosphere of Everwater's College.
What about vaping and the effects on the lungs? It was a symbol of we can.
Rahman was a man of the city, you hear me?
You're inside the Rahman Experience.
It's the Rahman Experience.
The Rahman Experience.
The knowledge that he dropping, most dismissive, make you curious.
And we can't mess this up, cause you know he gon' be furious.
He bring the news to you, cause it's the truth, ain't no stopping it. Say you didn't know, well, here's the proof coming from
Rahman Johnson, ain't no straight out of Compton. Duval County with that weight that we rocking. Now you tuned in to the Rahman Experience.
Hey there, welcome back to the Rahman Experience. What's going on? And I hope you enjoyed part one of my book launch. Pretty cool, huh? I would go read some poetry or do some other stuff, but you're going to hear it anyway. No news today because, of course, we got the show. I mean, it's a huge show, and it's so much time. I don't want to hold you too long, so I won't keep you an incredibly long time, but I will tell you that you can always have contact with me on our social media platforms. You can find me at Rahman J. That's at R-A-H-M-A-N-J on Twitter. Also on Instagram, same name, at Rahman J. And on Facebook, Facebook.com/RahmanJFans. More to come, more news, more stuff. I can't wait to get back to the news because there's so much to talk about. However, I really want you to check part two of the book signing. And before I get out of here or get to the show, I want to say I'm so thankful for the People's Station Radio Network. The People's Station has done an incredible job. This DJ Chill, or DJ Chill Will, has put together some of the finest podcasters, DJs, and music this side of Mississippi. Hell, in the country altogether. And it's such a great experience to be able to work with these talented broadcasting professionals and have the Rahman Experience a part of that. So I don't ever say it enough, and I don't think that I ever could say it enough. So thanks, Will, for creating that platform to allow us to not only create and express, but also inform. All right, just after this, we'll be back with part two of the book launch in the Rahman Experience.
My name is Dr. Tony Fauci here at the National Institutes of Health. If you've recovered from COVID-19, your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. Please donate plasma now. You can literally save lives. There are thousands of locations across the country where you can donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
Welcome to the Rahman Experience.
We need to make it hype a little bit. We'll come back in. I have a piece. For those that don't know, you want to stay tuned for this. I'm coming up with another piece. Mr. Al Pete's going to be on the Wheels of Steel. We're going to talk for a minute, and he is going to rock. This track came from Ndambi, and when I heard it, it made me think of all the women that were lonely. So I have a piece in the book called Lonely Woman that was written to this track, and so Al Pete's going to kick it with me. We're going to have a good time. But first, let's kick it off again with the baddest band in the land. They are funky, they are lovely, they are amazing. Please put your hands together again at the Media Conclave. My fan, special formula. Let's go! Whoa, whoa! Come on, where my hand clap was at? Come on, put your hands together. We live in each other, ladies and gentlemen. It's good to see everybody. Now, come on! Listening to the tunes of the special form of the band, ladies and gentlemen. Let's do it like this. Come on. You make me happy, yeah. This you can bear. Well, you stood right beside me, yeah. Now I won't forget. Now we had our good time. This
as you can see, whoa, hurting each other, yeah, girl, it's a shame.
Hey, what's up, everybody? So, say hello. All right, it's my little man, Ken. Y'all say what's up to Ken. Say hello. Don't eat the mic. Okay, he's usually with me. That's why he's not wearing a mask. But my only family I got left. This is my little, you know, you never know when they're going to pop up, but they do. This is Kenyon. This is my little niece, Aubrey. Say what's up, Aubrey. That's Aubrey. Okay, and my cousin, Generica. Where's Generica? My family came to be a part. I know you're gonna go back. I know you want the book. We got some. Go ahead. We got something for you, okay? All right. Take him back out. Thank you, man. Want to say everybody. Go ahead. I'm gonna come get you in a minute, okay? He won't take him back for he's trying to keep the mic. Y'all in time for Kenya. Oh, he don't want to go. All right, Al Pete, you ready? You wanna stay? You want a mic? Go with Aubrey. She'll give you a play mic. This is how you trick them, y'all. This is how you trick them. You want to stay with me while I do my song? You just want the mic? And then he keeps saying, da-da. And I'm like, you can't call me that in public because people going to know my name. You want the mic or you want the book? Okay. Aubrey, take him to Generica. So, he loves staying around. This one is the next poem. I'm going to get you in a minute, baby boy. All right, we're going to let him stay. Y'all cool with him staying around? All right, come on. You can cheer with me. All right, so this next poem was penned after I saw this. Al Pete, you with me on the ones and twos? You got a mic over there or no? No mic? Okay, can we get Al Pete a mic so we can talk to him a little bit? While we're waiting on Al Pete to come through, I'm going to share this poem with you. I'm not really one that's big on composed poems like that, but I met a couple of people who asked me to come and give them a poem for their wedding. And I went up to this wedding. I met these two folk. I mean, and it was amazing a moment. I got you, baby boy. And it was an opportunity to call them forth. And one thing we know when it comes to love is that you need to be able to bring everybody in the room with you. And Maya Angelou said something that was so poignant. She said, I come as one, but I stand as 10,000. And I wrote this poem about love. It's about the two who became one. And as I kind of how I feel about this little man. You know, when he got here, he stole my heart, and now he's my little dude. I got you. We're going to get you a mic. All right, this is I Call Them Forth while we're waiting on Mr. Al Pete. We're going to get you in a second, man. I call them forth from yesteryear to over there. I call them forth, the nameless ones, the blameless ones. I call them forth, the leaders, the seekers, the creators, the beers. I call them forth. With drum rhythms of circadian synchronicity, we call them forth. They share the moment. The two who come as one, yet stand as 10,000. They the ones who spoke to deities with unpronounceable names. They the ones who crossed and thrived. They the ones who cleared the landscape with their blood and laid the foundation with their words. They the ones who built monuments of their sojourn with their bones. They the ones who survived in silence. We welcome their essence from far and near. We sit in their presence and call them here to hallowed ground because we said so. Alafia, Akwaba, Kunjani, Jambo, Indamin Waleshu, Salam, we call them forth. In every way, in every place, we celebrate because of you. This unrequited love was an indicted love. This unsanctioned love was still sent from above, and you see, that's what made it right. This unbelievable love, this unretractable love, this irreplaceable love is the liberation of life. Our celebration embraces the presence that you have in the pith of your existence, and it all leads to now. In our tongue, we speak gratitude, thanking you for celebrating our blessing with your presence. Your work here continues as you return to the beyond, and we know and rest well, embracing your teaching and your being and your loving and your seeing and understanding that we called them forth. And they came. Ashe. And they let me do that poem at a wedding. I thought that was pretty cool. So I'm thankful for that. Hey, is my dude okay? Kenyon, all right. You know, they fall. Like, he cry all the time. And then 20 seconds later, he's ready for some food. So you give him some goldfish snacks. He good. Organic, of course. All right. So, Mr. Al Pete, how you doing, man?
All is well. How about you, brother?
I am honored to be a part of this thing with you, man. Thank you for coming and blessing us on the wheels of steel. Tell us a little bit about MPN, Mr. Peterson's Neighborhood.
So first off, congratulations to you and your book.
Yeah.
MPN, Mr. Peterson's Neighborhood, we are independent media company specializing in DJing, podcasting, music, singing, rapping, all that other good stuff. So for more information, mpn-llc.com. Come get you some.
MPN has been doing a lot of fun stuff as well, because I think one of the things that you all did recently was Fly Socks and Tees.
Yes,
how did that go? You all had like 700 people on the stream, I think, man, at one point?
Yeah. At one point, it was, I know one day, Thursday, matter of fact, it was like definitely 500 solid.
Yeah, so during the whole...
This was an online event festival that I put together. We do an annual event called Fly Socks and Tees.
Yeah.
Where we... fellowship at one spot, and we come together and we wear our dopest shirts and our dopest socks. But due to COVID. Was like, listen, I'm gonna pull off one of my dreams. So the whole week we did podcasting, we did panels. Rodman, you was one of the host of a panel, yeah. And I want to thank you for that. But yeah, we did that for the whole week, and then that Saturday we just had a gang of DJs, man, and just trying to bring the community together. Online, you know what I'm saying? So we did the whole weekend. It was great.
I'm glad you could kick it here with us, man. And yeah. Again, I'm looking forward to Fly Socks and Tees. And one of the things, you were like, you got every pair, I think, of Adidas they ever made, like from the beginning of the company.
Not yet.
Well, if they want to sponsor it, you will. If they want to kick some... Adidas, if you're watching, make sure you take care of my man, Mr. Al Pete.
Indeed.
But it was one of the most amazing experiences, and we look forward to Fly Socks and Tees, because this was the first time that you went into a social justice thing where you had panel discussions and that kind of thing on it. So
yeah, definitely. We definitely wanted to go with the educational route, but informative route.
Yeah.
I wanted to be able to touch back with my community. And I felt like in the climate that we're in, definitely needed to speak on what was going on around us. And if people didn't know what was going on around us, bring awareness to it. And we're not just the entertainment company. You know, we want to make sure we promote everything community-wise, you know?
Gotcha. All right. This is a poem. It's called Lonely Woman for Phyllis. And I literally put in there, for Phyllis and those who are lonely. And when I saw, when I heard this, this was the Steppers mix, and it was in Dombey, and I heard it, and it was like, I gotta do something to this. So this is called Lonely Woman, and check it out. Hope you like it. Lonely. A lonely woman. And there she was, as beautiful as could be, more exotic than the eye could see, for it was just she, lonely. A lonely woman not ready for a man, frankly not ready for anything, but where she sat, many longed to stand. Her face, beautiful. Her posture, impeccable. Her hair kinky like pre-sheared lamb's wool. A lonely woman. But she was still lonely, trying to protect her heart. No one took the time to see what she was going through. I mean, no one knew. They really just didn't know. Inside, she was crying and dying 1,000 times from the way she was treated in lies. You see, she was a lady because she chose to be. No one really knew her pain, for her virtues were amazing. But if only I had known that she was lonely. There was a loneliness. There was something else that I couldn't possess. For she and me just couldn't be. She was lonely. In the beginning, she was the belle of the ball, like the princess royal going from person to person and spreading a joy. Like a honeybee pollinating nature's garden, she was. Her beauty was legendary, but to her mother's instructions, she was contrary when she saw him. He was just like her mother described, and just like her father warned. Still, he was what she wanted. Her heart skipped a beat, and she thought this would make her complete. In an instant, she imagined love with him. She imagined his love, not like others he was. She was lonely. Her soul made her, so she thought. Oh, so lonely. Looking to help her heart. You see, it happened. They were together, she and he, making music and melody. It was all she hoped it'd be. He touched places inside of her that she never knew could be. And she wanted more. Walking with her man, she felt like a queen as subjects stopped to gaze. She knew it was only a precursor to the night. The love and heart to see it was right. She, dark space in a place where her beauty reigned supreme. She, a place where she could be the freak she needed to be. She, head under toe, over elbow, behind back, like that. For she was lonely, deep in the annals of ecstasy, almost piercing her lonely need. No matter what was done, he was the one, or so she thought, but couldn't place it. Still lonely, lonely woman. She was lonely. You see, she had invited him into her temple, and there was love to cherish her like she knew he could. In her mind, he was her god and she was his goddess. Nightly, they sacrificed to each other with offerings and tributes and promises of the future as time progressed. You see, the love digressed and there was distress. There would be thieves in the temple this night, beautiful sister trying to make it right. She was there. Out in the jungle, making her way to provide. But the entire time, she's thinking about the offering that she'll make tonight. Powerful thoughts invade her mind, making her pursue her journey before the appointed time. It made her get up and rise. So she left the place for her sacred place, and into the temple she did. She left the place for her sacred space, and into the antechamber she went. Preparing to take a trip on high. But there on the altar where she had made so many sacrifices over and over again lay another. She was worshiping her God in her temple on her night. And she was lonely. Lonely woman. Still so lonely. A lonely woman waiting to possess her love. So she was calm, poised even, never one to be caught out of style, still a lady. She made herself known, and the ritual ended quickly. She defiled, moved forward, and said, "You have defiled my temple. You have degraded the sanctity. You have taken my love. Leave here now." And they left her to be, and she left to flee, leaving the lonely woman there to be alone. And this is as it was, but not the same way. With sage she smudged, candles she burned, trying to erase the pain, but it was in vain. It was too much to bear. So she reached for the apothecary's cure to take her from there, ready to leave this place, to move from this space. A supernumerary few was all it took. And it was no longer. She was no longer lonely. If only I had known. If only I had known. If only I had known that she was lonely. Lonely woman. All right, y'all like Lonely Woman? It's a kind of deep poem. It's a little dark. Y'all do know she died at the end, right? I just, you know, y'all got. I'm just saying, some. I read it to somebody. It was like, well, why she took the pills? You know, I'm usually a very fun and jovial person, but it made me think of all the, like Phyllis Hyman. You know, honestly, I think, and so many of the other, you know, it almost one of my favorite singers is Jasmine Sullivan. I'm sure many of you love Jasmine, and. I remember a few years ago when Jasmine was just fed up with the industry and I just saw so many parallels in her life that her being from Philadelphia and Phyllis, and I stopped to pray and meditate and send some positive vibes her way because I didn't want to see her like Phyllis Hyman. So I'm so glad that Jasmine Sullivan's got a new project and she's doing well, and I want stories like this to be told about things that happened in the past, and hopefully no one has to be lonely because we have people around. So thank you. Thank you, Mr. Al Pete, for that. Thank you for the band. That was amazing. All right. So before we get back to the band, I want to I wrote a Facebook post. My mom, when she passed away, this was I got to share this with you before I write. You know, this is kind of deep for me, and I think I'm OK. But it's a little tough for me. So my mom died. I had just done a movie. Like I said, I'm an actor, and I've been acting for a while. And I did a movie, The Slave Narratives, with Markeisha Freeman. And it turned out to be a great movie, and it was a reading of The Slave Narratives. And the night before, I was hosting the Boutillion for Jack and Jill, and Mom was supposed to go. She didn't feel well, so she stayed home. And I got back. We laughed a little. And the next morning, we sat in her bed, and she watched the movie. And MJ, you were at my mom's funeral. I think you remember me telling the story. We watched the movie together, and we had a good time, and she was laughing, and she was in great spirits, and we believed the cancer was in remission, but the universe knew better. God knew it was time. And as I think back on it now, I'm so excited. Before I share this with you, I'm so excited that not a lot of us, especially today, you know, I was blessed to be able to actually have a funeral for my mama. A lot of folk can't have memorials and funerals. You know, you can only have 10 people today. And so I send love to all of them. But I was blessed to be able to have her as long as I did. But I was also blessed to be able to be right there with her at that moment. My mom didn't suffer a lot. She was ill, but she wasn't down. And I remember her, she was going to go to the restroom while we got ready to go worship that morning, on Sunday morning. And I said, I was going to get dressed, and she said, well, I feel a little weak. And I said, well, I'll help you up so you can go to the restroom. And I went over to her side of the bed. I was in her bed, and I helped her up. And while I was pulling her up, we said, 1, 2, 3, and I held her up, and I saw her look me straight in the eye. And in that moment, she was gone. Just that quickly. And I didn't know that she was gone. I knew something was wrong. I just didn't know. And I'm shaking her and trying to do CPR and calling 911 and all the things you're supposed to do. But there was a peace within me because I was right there. I was there with her. And there is no amount of money in the world. There is no thing that I could be given that would take the place of having that moment. And what I learned and understood is that in this space and time, the power that removed her soul from her body in that moment, clearly, if it took her soul away, it had to touch me. So as I move through life and I do things like publish books and I got another book on the way and I'm working on another degree and I'm doing other stuff, when all of that stuff comes around, I cannot be surprised, because I was in the presence of greatness when that power touched and took my mom's soul away. And I can't do anything but smile and be thankful for that moment. So after I had a, you know, and I did cry, you know, come on, I'm a man, I cried. I had some time to process it. I wrote a Facebook post. That's what we do these days. And this Facebook post ended up becoming this poem, and I didn't realize it would be a poem, but it encapsulates the moment, the moments after what I felt. And if I knew I didn't have much time, I may have done things a little differently, but at the end of the day, I did all I could. And even though I wanted to do more, there's only so much that I could have done. So this is what I wrote right after that moment, and it's called If I Knew I Didn't Have Much Time. If I knew I didn't have much time, I'd have found a brighter way to shine, a more exclusive way to be, so that you'd be proud of me. If I knew I didn't have much time. If I'd have known it'd be so quick, I'd have never gotten sick, so only smiles would light our way as we enjoyed both night and day. If I knew I didn't have much time. If I knew I didn't have much time, I'd have, if I'd thought you'd leave this space, taking all your style and grace, I'd have tried to learn even more before you entered heaven's door. If I knew I didn't have much time. However, what I knew not made me wise. For my bliss, it made me blind to the possibility of today. So I loved you fiercely evermore. I believe I brought honor to your door. I treasured each moment of dark and light. I learned from your tenacity, your strength, your might. Yes, the time was short, but I'd do it all the same. For what some see as loss, for me, is glorious gain. For the grand love that you had for me here is greater and stronger and boundless over there. So no, we didn't have much time. But that time I'll cherish, yours and mine. And now I see that it was just enough time. Simply divine. So, want to get back to the band because I want to uplift it a little bit. And I'm going to come and say goodbye. But Reg, I want to hear y'all kick it some more. Like, we're out here partying and dancing, even though we're distanced here. Distanced, and everybody is masked up. I'm so thankful to have these brothers. I want to say again to each and every one of the folk that are watching and listening, I'm going to try to get to all of your questions. And when I come back next, I'll answer those questions. But I want to say shouts out to the band. I want to make sure that I give them, I'll give them a shout out when I come back. But again, they've been, you know, this event, and special thanks to Cedric Matthews. I got a whole thank you thing prepared, but I'm going to be shouting y'all out all the time, sending your business. But thank you for everything that you've given to allow me to put this together. Wow.
It's true, but you try to hide. you turn down love like it's really bad, yeah. Now you can't give what you never had, yeah. Well, bless your soul, you can fool a few. Now I know the truth, and so do you.
Got to sing the song, y'all.
Can't hide love, baby. I bet you. Can't hide love. Feel it inside. Yeah.
It works.
You can't pretend that it's nothing. Girl, I look in your eyes and see you can. Yeah. So why not stop? Try to run it high. You won't find out if you never try.
Right now, put your cell phones up side to side. Let's move. Come on. That's right. Come on. Grown folk. For that parent taking care of the kids going to school, come on.
Feel good.
I need to feel that formula tonight. Let's work.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right. All right. Feel, I need to feel you over here. Just to let you know tonight, in case you ain't know, you rockin' with the formula all night long. Yes, sir. And that white, nah, come on. That's right. I hope y'all enjoying Rahman Johnson and the book signing, the book reading, the poem. I hope y'all enjoying Special Formula, DJ LP. We live in Media Conclave. Yep. Thank you, sir.
Would you mind if I touch, if I kiss, if I held you tight? In the morning light, yeah. Now would you mind if I say how I feel to the lead tonight? Again, cause I never felt this way in my heart before. Tonight, yeah, yeah. Would you mind if I look into your eyes and I'm hypnotized and I lose my pride? Yeah. Now would you mind if I make love to you till I'm satisfied once again? Cause I never felt this way in my heart before. Cause love has found its way in my heart tonight. Sing with me, come on. Hands up, side to side. One more time tonight. Would you mind? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Rock and roll. Let's work a little bit. Till I'm satisfied. Look into your eyes till I feel tight. Make love to you till I'm satisfied. Won't look into your eyes.
can boogie on down. upon a drink. I know
life ain't always what it seems. Oh yeah,
what you see, your love so clear.
That's what I'm talking about. Whoa, the energy! Jacksonville. I know we had some people from London, England. I saw London was watching. Take this off because I'm back up here and y'all got my mic sanitized. Boy, that is what you call energy. Shouts out to everybody from around the world. I had some folk from Nigeria, and it is tomorrow in Nigeria. They were tuning in, so thank you so much to all of my crew from there. Thank you to all the folk at Edward Waters College. One time, y'all give yourselves a big hand. The folk at the Media Conclave. Woo! This spot right here, this is where it's at. So thank you to all of you who have made this event successful. My homie wasn't able to make it, but I gotta give a shout out to my mellow, my man, one of my manifestors, Damian Lamar. Check him out, Damian Lamar Music, Professor Clock. Go check him out. Next time, you coming through. Next time, Damian Lamar, he's definitely coming out. Also, MJbaker, come and give a bow, a socially distanced bow. MJbaker, thank you so much for coming to be a part of things. Say hey and bye. You got to come where the camera can see you. A little closer. Right there. Okay, I'm going to step back. There it is. MJbaker. Mr. Al Pete. You can find MJbaker's information all over my social media. Come on, Mr. Al Pete. Come and take a bow. Mr. Al Pete is my friend. We met at the band, in the band. Y'all ain't know I was an instrumentalist. We was in the band at Reball Senior High School. Mr. Al Pete. There it is. That's what we met almost 30 years ago. Golly. Woo, we go back. All right. So, I want to leave you. Thank you all. Again, you can go and check out. Also, Nova Music. Shout out to you, Nova. Thank you so much, my brother. And I want to remind you that you can go pick up this book, Living, Loving, Letting Go. It's time for us to get out of here, but you can pick it up. Barnes & Noble, Books a Million, definitely Amazon.com. But most importantly, I want you to buy it at RahmanJohnson.com because, you know, y'all, they keep the money at the other places. So go to my site to get the book. Hope you enjoy an absolutely iconic evening. This is the first time that I'm here at the Media Conclave, but I will guarantee you, said I told you, Reg, I told you, it won't be the last. All right, I want to leave you with a quick piece of prose, and this one is, and we're going to play it out. Ryan Sinclair is joining us. Let's give Ryan Sinclair a round of applause. My brother. I've been banging with him on the drums since I was a little kid, man. Ryan Sinclair is here with us tonight, and we're going to do some magical things with him in the future. But I want to remind you that there is power in a name. So as I leave you tonight, I want to thank you for being a part of this event, of my book signing. Thank you to all my friends in the band. Thank you to all of you for buying a book. Thank you for all the sales that's going to happen. And thank you for the folk that's going to share this so other people will buy it and hopefully get someone inspired. Again, living, loving, letting go. Go get it. I want to leave you with a poem by my friend Pearl Klieg. She wrote this poem some years ago for Legends Ball. And Ryan and I were just talking about power being in the names. And when you look at the acknowledgments of my book, there's so many people that have passed along. Abu Kareem, Shadidi Ama, Adiwole Omowale Okulumele, here in Jacksonville. All these brothers and sisters that have been a part of the diaspora and a part of our growth. I got to say it since I've already called her earlier, but our queen mother, Celeste Danzler. Me and Sister Padrika were just talking about her. Man, you ain't never seen. This sister brought belly dancing to Jacksonville. Wasn't no black folk doing belly dancing in Jacksonville, but she did and created a business and a school out of it. We have so much history and culture in this community. And so I leave you with this because there's power in a name. I want to see you again. Make sure you share this. And I can't wait to fellowship with all of you. This is by Pearl Klieg. We speak your name. Because we are freedom, born of freedom, who was born of freedom from as far back as time begins, we speak freedom. Because we are wisdom, who was born of wisdom from as far back as time begins, we speak wisdom. Because we are strength, born of strength, who was born of strength, who was born of strength from as far back as time begins, we speak strength. Because we are magic, who was born of magic from as far back as time begins. We speak magic. We are gathered here to speak the names of those far and near, those who come to gather here, sons and daughters of yesterdays and tomorrows, so that we could be something better and truer and deeper. Because of the shining example of our own incandescent lives, we are here to speak the names of tomorrow's yesterdays. We speak your name. Dr. Maya Angelou, Shirley Caesar, Diane Carroll, Elizabeth Catlett, Ruby D., Catherine Dunham, we speak your names. we speak your names. You could not have known how we watched your every move and how we hung on your every word when you were on television or the radio or making a film. Your vision was what carried us into tomorrow's yesterdays, and we made it plain because you allowed us to break deeper. You allowed us to dig truer. You allowed us to dig better. And we and our little black boy and little black girl bedroom sat down holding that pretend microphone as a brush and singing and speaking and being. And today we speak your names. We speak your name, Roberta Flack and Aretha Franklin, Nikki Giovanni, Dr. Dorothy Height, Lena Horne, Coretta Scott King, those who came before. We speak your name. You taught us that the mysteries of true love sometimes were harder to unravel than the things above. But we know we celebrate your willingness to continue to search for love and dignity by holding on to it all. Like the beauty that comes from many forms, we don't fall. We are speaking names and sometimes in recognition of superior skill and sometimes in an undeniable appeal and sometimes in the absolute refusal to face injustice. We are speaking the names. Naomi Sims and Tina Turner, Cicely Tyson, Alice Walker, Dionne Warwick, Nancy Wilson, Oprah Winfrey. Today, we speak your names. Because we are freedom, born of freedom, from as far back as time begins, we speak freedom. Because we are wisdom, who was born of wisdom, from as far back as time begins, we speak wisdom. Because we are strength, born of strength, as far back as time begins, we speak strength. We celebrate your courage and your spirit, your genius, your loving kindness. We thank you for showing us how to fly, and now we repay you by flying. We stand here better and truer and deeper. And tonight, we speak your name. We speak your name. We speak your name.
Mogo unto pwe masotoni. Mogo unto kweri masotoni. Mogo unto kweri masotoni. Mogo unto kweri masotoni. Ela milawe, oye mi yawa, obe mi bewe, osa mi baba, ode mi dewe, ofa mi fawa, papa indigo, mase baba.
All right, so there it is. What a great show. We started it out with great poetry, and we ended it out with African drumming and a great poem by Pearl Klieg. I hope that you won't find it robbery to go out and buy my book, Living, Loving, Letting Go. You can find it at Amazon.com or at all major retailers. But thank you, thank you, thank you. I can't say it enough. And I look forward to seeing you for the rest of the season right here on The Rockman Experience. Be amazing.
The Rockman Experience. The Rockman Experience. The knowledge that he dropping most dismissive make you curious. And we can't mess this up because you know he gonna be furious.
He bring the news to you because it's the truth. Ain't no stopping it. Say you didn't know. Well, here's the proof coming from
Rockman Johnson. Ain't no straight out of Compton. Duval County with that weight that we rocking. Now you tuned in to
The Rockman Experience.